there's a way you tune it. If you want it to match the other instruments, say the guitar, you know. So it's very simple. It's like a song, actually. Tumnichanda. Meaning the music, the translation, the music is disturbing, you know.
I grew up watching my grandfather playing a titi, but really, I didn't develop the interest. This came much later, after watching a Japanese woman. So I'm like, wow, if this woman can come all the way from Japan and learn our culture and can play the instrument so well, who am I not to play it?
It was a song that would be the launching pad for her music career, introducing Suzanna Owiyo to the world.
When I started my career, I didn't know that people would appreciate me singing my own composition, because I started as a dancer, started as background vocalist, so I used to work with a team. But when I sang this song, Kisumu 100, on my own and on guitar, and everybody kept on asking, where have you been, where have you been? So I used to tell them, I've been around. It's only that I got the opportunity to be discovered then, yeah, at that time, at the right time, yes.
At the time, however, society was not ready for Suzanna Owiyo. It was cynical and judgmental, more so about a woman choosing that path.
I started as a dancer. You know, I was dancing dombolo, I used to wear bikers, you know, things. People really were like, wow. Mpaka, you know, guys used to tell my dad, hey, na ule ni msichana wako kweli, you know? Like, do you know what really your daughter is doing? Ule asha haribika, macha oketre. Ipande gari gani, ili nifike, ninapokwenda. Ipande gari gani, ili nifike. I said, let me follow my dreams, I mean. Let me chase my dreams.
She's one of Kenya's most popular singers. Can you please put your hands together for Degari and Suzanna Owiyo?
All right, let me see your hands, everybody.
Her focus propelled her to heights she had only imagined, performing for the high and mighty across the world.
Performing for Nelson Mandela, that was something extraordinary. I don't know how to put it. When I got this call from the organizers who wanted me to be on that platform, I said, wow. I mean, and looking at the list of guys who are going to be there, talk of Oprah, talk of Will Smith, talk of, you know, everybody. I said, oh my God, wow, this is quite a great thing. And why me? You know, at times you even pinch yourself. You're like, oh my, why? You know, when you believe in what you do and you have a passion for what you do, I think the door normally opens up.
It's a musical journey that has seen her recognized for her vocal prowess and her fusion mostly of traditional Western Kenyan music and contemporary rhythms, receiving such accolades as the Order of the Grand Warrior of Kenya Award and recognition as a 4664 ambassador, which is Nelson Mandela's global campaign that promotes human rights.
Whenever I compose my songs, I always think in mother tongue first. Then I can translate that into English if need be. You really have to know how to engage your audience, and especially when the audience, this is a new audience, just make sure that you learn the basics, you know. If it's saying hello in Japanese, saying how you doing, saying I love you, you know, I love you all, then you, wow, yeah, in their language.
At the heart of it all is her involvement in advocacy campaigns, her passion for creating awareness about social concerns. The acclaimed musician is a goodwill ambassador for the United Nations Environment Programme and is involved in a girls' empowerment campaign project titled Because I Am a Girl, initiated by Plan International.
I believe in educating a girl. And, you know, education is the best weapon you can give a person. if you want to change the world. And so parents out there, they need to be in the forefront and protect their girls. They need to treat them with dignity and respect.
Suzanna Owiyo has been referred to as the Tracy Chapman of Africa in reference to a famous award-winning American singer and songwriter. And with over 15 years in the music industry, she attests that more needs to be done.
In terms of laying proper structures, support from the government, I'm hoping that it can be made better. It's upon women in leadership to empower the fellow women. If we want to make a difference, you know, and if we are looking for better results, it's us women to support our own.
You can have what you want to have. Africa woman arise.
Salim Bilu, Citizen Weekend.